And at 14 in our poll of your favourite 80s hits, it's the Trevor Horn-produced classic that spent more weeks at number one in the decade than any other.
Two Tribes, the way the Frankies used to play it when I first met them, was totally different to the record. The whole thing was much more of a sort of punky stream of consciousness.
Two Tribes was our second record. Relax had just gone ballistic. So we were all over the place promoting Relax in other countries. Trevor was back in the studio tinkering and fiddling.
We're all sitting in the background waiting for this process to eventually evolve. So you're saying, I wonder what this is going to end up like.
This bit's good.
The thing was that Frankie were a modern band, so their records were made by a team of people, not by the actual band themselves. The band provided the attitude, but we made the record.
I remember one day going back in the studio and Trevor said, what do you think of this? And he put it on the big speakers and he pressed play, and I thought, oh my God. It kicks ass, doesn't it?
I think Two Tribes took us about 2.5 months. In fact, Elvis Costello came to the studio, made an album, and then came back again to remix a couple of the tracks, and we were still working on the bass on Two Tribes. And I said, yeah, and we haven't quite cracked it yet. That's what's really alarming.
But Two Tribes wasn't just about the record. The song was at the centre of a multimedia marketing campaign. Frankie T-shirts were everywhere, and a controversial video got the nation talking.
Instead of some massive fight, Two Tribes go to war, we whittled it down to representatives. Reagan and Chernenko, who was the boss of Russia for 10 minutes or so. I like the extras. When they saw these guys going for it, we didn't have any trouble getting their energy levels going.
The 80s was the decade of the 12-inch remix, and Two Tribes pushed the appetite for reworkings of the song to the limit, with version after version released during the song's 9-week stay at the top spot.
Two Tribes, we knew we'd have to have a very big 12-inch. The 12-inch was as important as the single.
My name's Ted.
My name's Mark.
My name's Nat.
Mine is the last voice that you will ever hear.
My name's Mark and my name's Nash, my name's Perth. We were standing in this club, it was the first time we'd heard it. It was like, what's going on there? How's he got that? This is unreal, you know.
My name's Perth.
But the track's just monster, isn't it?
Mine is the last voice that you will ever hear. Don't be alarmed.
At 13, it's the first...